knowing that we will not let what we see affect what we know in our hearts, that the enemy won't get the best of us, that we know that there's no condemnation for those that are in Christ Jesus, that we are to count it all joy when we face trials of any kind, and that when we are involved in struggles in life, Paul says that he has learned to be content in all situations. So, Father, I pray that for all of us here today. I mainly pray to you for moving the rain, changing the weather forecast, so we can get together in your name, and we can sing your praises, we can worship you, we can bless you. We want to love on you. So will you receive this as a very fragrant offering into the throne room? We praise you, we honor you, we love you. God, and we all need Jesus because life is hard. Anybody know that? And it might not get easier. Not to rain on the parade, but this, Paul says that it's all momentary affliction for the joy to come. Do y'all understand what that means? Even if you live to be 102, I mean, the little thing at the top is for Mother Teresa. She's as old as, you know, was old as dirt. Okay, so
yeah.
She suffered a lot of persecution. Although she did a lot of stuff, she suffered persecution. So life is hard, and it may not get easier, but it's considered momentary affliction to the joy. That's what we keep our eyes on. How many times have you heard me say, don't look around you, look there. And just at what I was saying earlier, don't let what you see affect what you know. Those clouds look like it would be raining in all of the DFW area. But it's not raining here. And I was talking to my kid this morning, and she was telling me, it's okay sometimes if you're not always happy and always joyful because you're just human, and, you know, and I said, wait a minute, time out. I'm not just human. I'm eternal. I've been born again. And yes, happiness sometimes is situational, but joy is always abundant and present as long as I keep my eyes on the Father. If I take every thought captive unto the obedience of Christ, then I believe in God, and all I need is Jesus. I don't need anything else. I was listening to Dan Moeller. And he was talking about a home Bible study he did when he first got saved by the Lord 26 years ago. And he was telling this home group, he said there was like 50 people in his living room, way more than they expected. He was sitting on his knees between two people, and he'd been worshiping God, and he was holding his shirt, and he was talking about, I love my wife. This is my wife. I love her. These are my two children, my son and my daughter, and I love them. And this is my house that we're all sitting in. And this is my health. This is my body. But I don't need my wife. I don't need my children. I don't need my house. And he said that it was just the spirit, and it caused him to pull on his shirt and button cloth. I don't even need my health. Just need Jesus. God can take all of that away, even health. If we keep our eyes on Jesus, then this song, We Believe in God, changes everything. Back to your regularly scheduled program.
Oh.
So I could praise your great and matchless name all my days, so let my whole life be a blazing offering, a light that shouts and sings the greatness of the King. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God forever. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. Take my life and let it be.
website, something MP3 files. I'll show you there before we get out of here.
Trust in the Lord are a strong mountain, they will not be moved. Those who trust in the Lord are a strong mountain, they will not be. Jesus, you will not be changed.